Serendipity is one of Alfred Chuang's favorite words, and it seems only appropriate considering the life journey of this alumnus who has been called one of the greatest CEOs of our time.
I went to a high school in Canada. On my way back to Hong Kong for a summer holiday, and got stuck in the Bay Area because the plane was grounded. Serendipitously, I went, then rolled along, and then ended up at a school.
The grounded plane caused Chuang to stay with family friends in California, who convinced him to remain in the United States to continue his education. Chuang sought out UC Davis for his master's degree because it was a quintessential college town with great academics.
I ended up at Davis, and then I ended up staying. By the way, it's almost funny, because the way that you get your visa to come to this country is to vow you're never going to stay after you finish college. I didn't do any of it. You know, I stayed and it all worked out.
While earning his degree, he found a job in a research lab. It was there that Chuang, one of the world's most influential and innovative leaders in e-commerce and e-business infrastructure, found his life's passion.
So research I was working on, being a kid, you'd be happy to work on any research, right? And as a geek, you were able to get onto having a computer. I mean, this is not just a computer. This is a serious computer. And I was so addicted to this thing. I would have paid to do this research, and they pay me.
After graduating, Chuang worked for Sun Microsystems and then co-founded BEA Systems in 1995. In less than 2 years, it became one of the leading e-business infrastructure software companies with 91 offices in 38 countries. BEA Systems was acquired by Oracle in 2008.
The last company that I was involved building, we ended up with 5,000 people. You know, after 12, 13 years. And people told me that, you know, 15, 16,000 people have gone through that company during his lifetime, and it changed the world. And I think this is a thing that we almost always underestimate. The success of anything really comes from the people. It doesn't come from that technology. Technology doesn't build technology. The people that build the technology, people that makes and implement these technology make things happen.
Chuang founded a new startup, Magnet Systems, that is working to further unite technology with the user.
I have always had a passion of how do we get computing power as close to the individual as possible. And I think we're getting really close.
Chuang's UC Davis experience continues to inspire him.
Another professor, Chip Martel, Chip still, I think, at time teaches at Davis. I think since retired. I seriously thought I met Einstein. He is Einstein. And it humbles you when you meet someone like him, because you said, how is it possible there's an individual that smart? Every morning I get up, I say, well, okay, I'm going to be smarter today. And I think of Chip. And these kind of things you're supposed to get out of college. That's precisely what I got out of Davis.
Chuang hopes to create similar opportunities for the next generation of Aggies.
If it wasn't for that experience, I wouldn't be here today. Right, I wouldn't be living here, I wouldn't be working here, I wouldn't have founded the company and sold it and started another one. None of that would have happened.
Chuang has been an active volunteer and distinguished lecturer for the College of Engineering, and he encourages other alumni to give back as well.
Education has to be the way that can change the world. It is not an option, I think, for anyone to think you can just go to these schools, earn a degree, be successful, and think about you don't have to go back and contribute to it. I don't think that's an option.